everyone is aware about the condition of water in India. When you talk about Delhi, then it's like horrible condition, like you can get many diseases. Based according to one of the report which was delivered by World Health Organization, it is estimated that around 2 billion people live in water stressed countries and is expected to be increasing in some area as a result of climate change and population growth.
सेशन हेलो एवरीवन, गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू दोस्तों, और स्वागत आप सबका विद प्रिप के सेशन पे. एंड टुडे वी हैव अनदर स्पीकर, और बहुत ही मतलब आज मैं उनका जब आपको बायो बताऊंगा तो बच्चों आपको बहुत सुन के मतलब कुछ एक स्पेशल बात अबाउट दिस रिसर्च पेपर ऑल्सो आपको बहुत हैरानी भी होगी कि इन दिस एज मैम हैज़ पब्लिश्ड. मैं अगर फर्स्ट पॉइंट अगर उनको इंट्रोडक्शन के लिए अगर ब्रीफ करूँ तो मैम हैज़ पब्लिश नियर अबाउट 28 रिसर्च पेपर्स, और वो भी इस एज में. ओके, सो लेट मी स्टार्ट विद इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ मैम. वी हैव डॉक्टर गरिमा राठी टुडे, एंड शी हैज़ डन इज PhD फ्रॉम इन 2020-21 इन केमिस्ट्री, एंड शी वर्क इन द नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इम्यूनोलॉजी इन कोलेब्रेशन विद द जवाहरलाल नेहरू यूनिवर्सिटी इन 2020-21 ऑल्सो. After that, she joined the IIT Delhi and as a project associate in the Department of Material Science and Engineering. In September 2022, she joined University at Barcelona, Spain, as a postdoctoral researcher on a European-funded, it is a scholarship name. Ma'am can like explain it more about it. Okay. Then onwards, I think ma'am has like a aim at project has an aim at developing new technologies and solutions based on the industrial and urban symbiosis concepts. Okay, for local and regional collaboration among diverse sectors, improving the sustainability of the use of industrial and social resources, starting from the waste water and waste materials. Recently, ma'am has started working as a Marie Curie postdoctoral research fellow on the project entitled NanoProtect, aiming to engineering antimicrobial activities, antimicrobial nano coating for the hospital textiles to prevent the spread of healthcare associated infections. Ma'am has published near about 28 research papers in various international journals. और अभी तक की जर्नी में उन्होंने इतने ज़्यादा पेपर रिसर्च पेपर निकाल दिए, भाई बहुत बड़ी बात है. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मैम, थैंक्स, थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग फॉर दिस सेशन टू गाइड द स्टूडेंट्स अबाउट देयर करियर. एंड अलोंग विद अस वी हैव डॉक्टर रवि तोमर, एंड आपको हर सेशन में वो कुछ अच्छे रिसर्चर्स प्रोवाइड करा रहे हैं, कनेक्ट करवा रहे हैं थ्रू हिज एक्सपीरियंस. एंड डॉक्टर रवि तोमर, he is a assistant professor at the SRM IIST University Delhi NCR campus. और एक बहुत interesting news भी आप सब बच्चों के लिए, वो हम later on share करेंगे. तो let's start the today's session. I think everything is okay. So ma'am, please start the session and please share your experience with the students.
Thank you, sir, for the introduction. And hello, everyone. I am Dr. Garima Rathi, and I'm currently working as Marie Curie postdoctoral fellow in Spain. And this is like one of the most prestigious postdoctoral fellowship in the entire world. And to get it, it's not like a big cake, but if you try, you can achieve it in the first try. Me and some of my friends have gotten in their first trial. So if I can do, then you guys can also do, because I think nothing is impossible. And now I will share you some of my work. So, okay, my presentation topic today is next generation nanomaterials for tackling emerging water contaminants design implementation strategies. And first of all, like, why do we need to clean the water? Like, why it's like everyone is aware about the condition of water in India. Okay, forget about the entire world, only in India, it's like the water is not that pure. And when you talk about Delhi, then it's like horrible condition, like you can get many disease, many other harmful health problems. So Based according to one of the report which was delivered by World Health Organization, it is estimated that around 2 billion people live in water-stressed countries and is expected to be increasing in some area as a result of climate change and population growth. And globally, at least 2 billion people use a drinking water which is contaminated by feces and other pollutants. The most important chemical risk in drinking waters are fluorides, nitrate, and other emerging contaminants such as pathogen, pharmaceuticals, pesticides, and microplastics. In 2020, it was estimated that 74% of the global population, 5.8 billion people, used a safely managed drinking water service, that is one located on premises, available when needed and free from contamination. Still, like, we have to reach the 100 to attain the 100%, if we need like 26% more, and it's like a big population. So in this presentation, we are going to deal with like few contaminants only. First are microbiological contaminants, second dyes, and third are the heavy metals and pesticides. So the first slides are for the microbiological contaminants, like what are those and why do we need to purify water. So for this work, we have designed like some nanoparticles, magnetic nanoparticles, which will be used for water disinfectant. Water pollution is a global concern, as water pollution is like water is highly polluted. It's highly polluted. Like, there are like different sources of water. There are different water pollution reasons. One is like oxygen depletion, the surface area, surface water, groundwater, by the chemicals, by thermal changes, oil spillage in the coastal areas, and suspended water, and microbial for sure. So generally, microbial contaminants are found in water. The microbiological contaminants which are found in water are bacteria, yeast, mold, fungi, viruses, protozoa, and their toxins and bioproducts. Fecal contamination, whether human or animal, is associated with pathogenic microorganisms. The presence of E. coli in wastewater provides evidences of fecal contamination, like which varies from 10 to power 9 colony forming unit to 10 raised to power 3 CFUs. CFUs is like just a like unit which we generally use to determine the presence. Like, if it's like 10, if you are able to kill the bacteria like 10 to power 3 CFU per ml, then it can be stated that the nanoparticle is 99.99% effective against that bacteria. So generally, we try to test all the nanomaterials which we design for both type of bacteria, gram positive, gram negative viruses. And metal oxides are basically more like silver, copper, cobalt, are used for as antimicrobial agents in most of the industries or most of the nanomaterial. But there are like some harmful effects of it. Like silver, okay, it can kill the bacteria, it can kill the viruses, but it's also toxic for the human cells, skin cells, and all the other organisms. They are like not biocompatible. So we have to design some strategies so that we can combine the biocompatible properties of few of the organic molecules which are present in the nature, bio-based molecules, with this metal-based substances, so that we can merge the biocompatibility with the antimicrobial activity of metals, leading to a nanoparticle or nanomaterial which is biocompatible also and which is antimicrobial also. So there is like we are trying to design some nanoparticles which can act in both the ways. Like, they are not toxic to the nature and they can recycled and reused. And second, they can kill the bacterias and viruses. Till now, we have only tested bacterial, because in our lab we have only bacterial testing facilities. But we are planning to test for another viruses which are present in nature. And why like water disinfections is necessary, and what are the problem with the current strategies which are introduced by different industries and the governments for purification, and what are the problems which are associated with these processes which we generally use in our in all the countries. The in disinfectants which we use to kill the bacteria and other microorganisms present in water are generally chlorine-based disinfectant like sodium, calcium, hypochlorite, chlorine gas, chlorine dioxide, ozone treatment. But they are successful in killing the bacteria, but there are like many disinfection bioproducts such as dichloroacetic acid, trichloroacetic acid, which can lead into many other disorders like cancer, bladder disorder, kidney, gastrointestinal disorders. So this is like a problematic for humans as well as for the animal. This is only the estimation of the human people, not with the animals. So if they are toxic for human, then they might be toxic for our other animals on the planet. And another issue with the chlorination process is that bacteria have the tendency of getting other problem is that bacteria have the capability of creating a resistance towards the antibiotics or any other things which we provide to them. And so we have to provide some nanoparticles for which the development of resistance is like slow, not as fast as in chlorine resistant as fast as the for the antibiotics or chlorine. So our approach was here to design safe by design nanofabrication of antimicrobial nanoparticles. First, we decided to design nanoparticles which were like safe by design strategy. Second, the production of bio-based silver phenol, silver doped magnetic nanoparticles which were coated with baleen to have antibacterial and antibiofilm properties. Okay, antibacterial property is like to kill the bacteria, but antibiofilm property is like the bacteria have the these are like the bacteria have the tendency to form biofilm. If they are like in stagnant, then these biofilm can create problem in most of the industries, like everywhere on the medical devices, on textiles. If they are like used, they are like they get exposed to the bacterias. So we have to tackle both the problems, antibacterial and antibiofilm, which are caused by the bacteria. So third is like we have third is that we try to decrease the biocompatibility by using a natural flavonoid, which is baleen, on the surface of silver magnetic nanoparticles and allow them to settle, like allow them to make a nanoparticle or nanocomposite, which is which have higher antioxidant property, which have higher antibacterial property, and which are also biocompatible to human cells. But the advantages of these nanoparticles till now, which we have explored, are like cost-effective, environmentally friendly technologies for nanoparticle synthesis and non-toxic bio-based nanoactives, which are not toxic for the nature. They are biocompatible with higher antimicrobial efficacy and lower risk of resistance development. The synthesis was very simple. It was just a precipitation synthesis in which the iron salts were added in a ratio of 1:2, and then sodium hydroxide was used to maintain the to increase the pH to 12, and then silver nitrate was added, and then baleen was added to coat the nanoparticles with baleen. Just a small like recap of what small brief of what baleen is. Baleen is basically a natural flavone, which is a type of flavonoid present in the roots of some plants which are present in China, more or less in China. The absolute bioavailability of baleen in different doses is ranged from 13.1% to 23.0%, and it has antimicrobial, antioxidant, anti-cancer, and anti-inflammatory properties that can be used for the treatment of several disease. And baleen is also one of the active ingredient of Chinese special herbal formula and is also listed in Japan as a Campo Medicine. So we evaluated the antibacterial efficiency of these nanoparticles against both the gram-positive and gram-negative bacterias. So we saw that the nanoparticles were effective for Staphylococcus aureus and also for the other negative. These are the gram-positive bacteria, and at the concentration of 0.1875, the bacteria was removed like till 80%, and at 0.375 mg per ml, the bacteria was killed. Like the bacterial removal was around like of 9.86 reduction. So it's like very high. Generally, when we have to report the antibacterial activity of any nanoparticle, we try to get the like log reduction values of around 3, because 3 is like 3 is considered as 99.99%. So above this, it will be very good. And okay, 2.09, which is at 0.94 mg per ml, still it's very good because it's like 99.9. When it increases like by one factor, it's more or less like lie within the range of 90 to 99% or 100%. So still it's like very good efficiency at 0.93, 0.94%. So the antibacterial activity of FAB nanoparticles against gram-negative bacteria was also evaluated, and it was seen that at the 0.094 mg per ml concentration, the log reduction was of 4, which is like very good at this lesser amount of concentration of nanoparticles. So next, we also tested it for E. coli, and it was also like effective against E. coli. Next, we also determined the anti-biofilm efficiency of the nanoparticles, which was into like generally in this process, what we do is like we first allow we add the nanoparticles with the mixture of bacteria in trypsin soya agar solution, and we allow the biofilm to be formed on the surface. Generally, the biofilm is formed on the surface of the on any of the surface. It's not like it will be in air like or in the solution. And we were trying to just eliminate, or we were trying to just avoid the formation of biofilm over the surface. So thing is like it's not only like toxic for many industries like antibiofouling or something. Like bacteria is present everywhere, and if it gets the perfect temperature and conditions like moisture conditions to grow, then you won't be able to see it so clearly, but it will be like very toxic.